This is the solution to Wex 1, 2, 3. Okay, so for part A, make a sketch. All right, so then between 1 and 4, all right. So then concerning L of X equal to 1 minus 2x minus 1, notice that 2x minus 1, you can't divide by 0, so I'm going to solve for 0 real quick to figure out where the problem is going to be. So this would be 2x is equal to 1, so x is half. So at x is half, if you were to plug in half, that'd be 2 times half is 1 minus 1. That'd be a 0. So that's telling you where, for this particular function, that there's an asymptote there. So if this is x and this is y, this line would be x is 0. At x is half, where the asymptote is. Then at x is 1, that's one of the boundaries of integration. So this is x is 1. And then 4, so if that's 1, you know, 4 is over here. So at 1, its height would be 1. So then this is the asymptote. There's something like this. Something like that. So the region is all of this. So that's the region, and then we want to sketch the solid. The trick is to you know, take these bounds, and you need to make them symmetric above and below. This is x is 1 and x is 4. So this one is high, and we need to make a symmetric point down there, and then this one is low, and a symmetric point down there. It bends like that, bend like that, and then to give some perspective, this is a solid. Then we're asked to compute the volume. Well, this would be integral 1 to 4 pi, and then the radius. Remember, this these solids are of revolution are understood to be collections of infinitely many infinitesimal cylinders. So the volume formula looks like add up pi r squared h. All right, so then a little bit of simplification is helpful. So pi integral 1 to 4, and then the most convenient way to write that is probably 2x minus 1 to negative 2, like so. a substitution may help. So I'll do the substitution W is equal to 2x minus 1. Then dw would be 2dx. Now we don't have 2dx, so I'll say dw over 2 is dx. Then I'll go ahead and switch the limits. W, when x is 1, is, you know, I gotta use this here. When x is 1, that'd be 1. And then W, when x is 4, would be 8 minus 1 is 7. So 7. As a result, the new integral is pi, integral 1 to 7. W squared, then dx becomes dw over 2. Alright, so then that division by 2, that can just be factored out. So pi over 2. And then w squared, its antiderivative is w cubed over 3. It's evaluated from 1 to 7. So then I could bring that division by 3 out to be with the pi over 2, so that it's pi over 6. And then I'll evaluate w cubed at the two positions there. So this would be 7 cubed and then minus 1 cubed. And I don't have the cube of 7 memorized. So that, that'd be 3, 4, 3, and then minus 1 would be 3, 4, 2. So pi over 6 times 3, 4, 2. Is 3, 4, 2 divisible by 6? Yes. So that'd be 57 pi. That's the answer.